Yes, trading with Fort Baca is better than any building we could build right now, but not better than any internal trade route we could make. So once we've used up all of our trade routes on internal trade, I'm definitely happy to trade with Fort Baca there. Kalashkova. When you're playing single player, probably most of your trade routes are going to go with trade with the AI since they have much better yields. But in a situation like this, where we're just by ourselves and then we've got the trade stations, trading with trade stations is going to be quite viable. Unfortunately, I should have gotten my internals up by now, but it's easy to get distracted. At least I find when I give commentary and play at the same time, it is definitely a multitasking experience. So even though I intended to get trade routes up early, that's not exactly what happened. Choose production here. Since there is Fort Barker around, we could go for a trade convoy. We do have the Rome-like 25% production boost, so we can go grab the Seto Nursery now. Once this thing becomes a full-fledged city, we're going to need the health to cover that. And let's go for the mine and the road. And a quest decision. Do I want plus 5% production of military units, or plus 1 production early game? Plus 1 production is definitely going to be much better there, so we'll go grab that. Alright, production here. I do want to get more of these basic buildings done so I can get the Rome bonus as much as possible. So, we'll build out the Pharma Lab and Thorium Reactor, and then we'll pop out the Missile Rover, take care of this guy, go build a colonist, sell that city, we'll sell the city to the north, and everyone will be happy. So, where? Okay, my soldiers are healed up. We can start walking forward here. Did that nest respawn? It certainly did. And as a result, we've still got a lot of aliens to deal with here. We definitely need an army. On the plus side, though, our units will gain experience for when we go and crush Baba Yetu for his insolence. Can't believe he killed two of our explorers and forced our third explorer to its death at the hands of these native aliens. Well, I can't believe it. I'm just, it's, you know, roleplay, mock outrage, what have you. I would have done the same, if I had a soldier there. Sweet opportunity to kill a bunch of explorer units. Lots of miasmic damage, and these guys are totally converging our location. At least we're standing in a forest, which I assume does give us some sort of a combat boost. No miasma. Let's see, if we attack there, it's a minor victory. Let's wait for them to attack into us, and the colonists will just have to sleep there as well. Road. And quest decision. Xeno ecology, additional explore module, or extra science. Extra science, please. Ah, yes, and we do have the other players on TeamSpeak if you haven't noticed by now, but I don't think I mentioned that at the start of the stream. Let's have a look at the scores again. Oh, scores are already up there. We are in second place on score. Hooray! Not that that means anything. And we have a massive horde of alien natives that we need to deal with. I think... Yikes. Our trade routes are... Well, one of them is going to get plundered here. It looks like we are either going to have to pump out a huge military and crush those guys, or swing by ultrasonic fences at ecology. That's only going to take us 4 turns. It also gets us the vivarium. Do we have deserts that would be enhanced by vivarium? Yes, we do. We've got a few desert tiles here and there. So I might swing by ecology. What happened here? Our soldier was killed. Ooh, that's bad. Now our colonist is in danger. At least they came into range of our outpost, which turned into a city just in time. We should be safe from these guys. I don't think the aliens heal, at least I hope they don't. That was always an advantage we had over barbarians in Civ 5, that they didn't heal. Let's go and build a road over there, and let's see, soldier killed, trade unit destroyed. Yes, it's been an ugly time for us here, but if we were to trade with these guys, that would go through the bugs. So let's trade with Fort Barca.
No more digging up my things, alright?
Okay. We can improve some more guys. I want the culture boosters here, I think. Palatine, I just hope they don't land somewhere. Ah, okay, so that's not really so much in the way for us. Although, getting a trade route up with them, we can't do that right now since we don't have any coastals on that side. Choose production. What do I want? Older Thrillac, yes. More culture, please, and next turn. Alright, Cleftro's made peace with Filthy, blah blah blah. That's just fine. Ooh, and apparently you can get achievements in multiplayer. I guess you could do that in Brave New World as well, but originally in vanilla, you could not get any achievement points in multiplayer. And where did all those bugs go? They just straight up disappeared. We should probably clear the nest while we still can, although this is risky. Yeah, that was definitely risky. We might lose that guy right there. But clearing the nest seems like a good plan. Zone of control should stop that, so let's keep walking here. Might be risky. Build out, and choose production. So, another trade convoy or more units. Let's go with a quick combat rover. And I would go and buy out some trade convoys now if those aliens weren't running around and pillaging my routes. Veterancy Grained, yes, a good time for an instant heal. A very good time for an instant heal. Star of Hope wants to know what I did in between my undergrad and my postgrad. Let's just say that PhDs in the life sciences at the University of Toronto take a long time. Alright, so... in the capital. Let's pop out a quick... I don't know how much I like these soldiers. I think they will be auto-upgraded as we get more affinity points. We could go for the trade convoy. I think that trade route would be safe. Alright, we'll go combat rover into missile rover. And we don't want to stand on miasma. That's also miasma. Let's just hide back here. Colonist will hang out there, hopefully be safe. Deal damage here. And this guy's healed up. Too many bugs around though. Hide back here. And with this road piece done, let's not build on the miasma. We can build on the hill. Trade convoy. Which of these trade routes would actually be safe? Here we go. And this guy's gonna die to miasma. 20 hit points left. How long is this mine gonna take? 2 turns? Alright, you'll take a break. Go hide in here and heal. Sleep. Meanwhile, I really want to get over and settle this city. But I don't want to stand in miasma and be surrounded by aliens. We don't have embarkation. Looks like we might be in trouble here, especially if the aliens are not too pleased that we killed a lot of their brethren. Rode up and workers. Put up a farm here, sure. All right, computing next turn. Throw out Shackleton.
Oh, can I send you a trade route without any repercussions here? Negative repercussions?
To who?
To you.
There is a siege worm that I'm slowly killing off, so mm-hmm. If it's sent to Citadella, it should be fine.
Can't reach Citadella, I'd have to send it to the Santo.
Right, city
can't
here.
Send it just yet.
City here?
Okay.
City here. City here. City here. Lots of plans for cities, but first we need army to deal with these aliens. So, this is our first multiplayer game, first game on Fast. One thing we would change is fewer early explorers and maybe another soldier early. And I do want to pick up that crashed satellite, so maybe yet 10. 19. Ah, we'll just call it 19. I really apologize, but the city is now called 19, and it will work on an explorer, although with the surrounding aliens, perhaps a missile rover. 22 turns, yikes. We are unhealthy, we'll just toss up the clinic. Fine. And these little cities really need the benefits of trade routes, but I can't do that until I clear out the aliens. So, more units here. Choose production, missile rover or combat rover. Let's pop a combat rover there and queue up a missile rover. Trade depots would be nice, but it's not going to help us while we're sieged by aliens. Hopefully these combat rovers will make short work of these natives. Yeah, they were there first, but we're humans. And from human-centered morality, this planet is ours. Fortify, fortify, and pharmify. Yeah, your PhD does sound pretty cool there, Star of Hope. I hope you get that job in the States that you were telling me about. Alright, 19 detects aliens and can shoot them. Perfect. And we can kill aliens here, sure. I'll go deal some damage. Boom. Combat rovers do seem a bit stronger than plain soldiers, and I don't know if we want to get into range of the two manticores here. We'll just keep hiding out here until we can get some more reinforcements, and we'll work on the road. I guess it would be cheaper if we built it in that shorter distance, although now with that wolf beetle there, at least we have the armor in the way to protect us. Combat rover, you guys will help with that, and the missile rover will head over towards Shackleton. Quest decision. We want worker speed or food from recyclers. Let's grab worker speed, although we have improved all the tiles that we wanted. Definitely a big change of pace from standard speed to fast speed here. Alright, combat rover attack. Yes, we will. Roads for connecting up the cities and faster troop movements. Combat rover here. We'll also join the alien busting party. We could get some flanking action going. I don't really want to have to stand in miasma. Kalashkova, I don't know how the rounding works with respect to turn completion on the units, but if 10% on workers rounds to a whole turn sooner, that's pretty sweet. And we did finish computers, so we can go and work on the spy agency. It would give us a nice flow of free science and or energy, plus some intel on the other players' capitals. But I really want to settle all these cities as early as possible, which means destroying these aliens and destroying Shackleton. Hopefully we didn't lose anyone there. No, just metrically gained.
If you want to send a trade route, you can now, because each worm is
there. And Tank has built the ectogenesis pod, which if I think is the wonder that boosts food. It was definitely a good-looking wonder, so good for him. Looks like he's planning things out. I don't think we have the tech for that. And minor victory only. Let's grab the insta-heal here. Keep on fighting, although later I might regret not getting the combat bonuses. But for now, that'll do. We are building roads in a single turn, though, so I don't know how that transfers over, Kalashkova, into your worker improvement build speed time chart, but note that. Lowbones says that the ectogenesis pod may as well be equivalent to the Hang Gardens, and that's typical tank play. I have played with Tank before, but not enough to get a good sense on his usual tactics, but it's good to know. And I think someone wanted to see some of the science something. I don't know where we can actually see graphs here. There is no traditional demographic screen. Decisive victory, pop him out. These guys will stay back to protect the workers, so fortify. And zone of control should protect this guy, but we'll find out. And another combat rover. Alright, we'll completely box these aliens off. Juice production over here, now we can get a trade convoy up. And developer virtue. Do I want to keep going down industry? 10% boost in every city of energy, that's pretty nice. Energy from basic resources, production towards wonders, I don't really want that. But health per trade unit, that does sound fairly useful. And I imagine that would be global health, which makes it even better. Of course, we don't have a lot of trade units now, but many trade units is the plan. Well, right now, Captain Gregor asks what my opinion of the tech web is. Right now, it seems full of possibility and lots of interesting things we could do with it, but that's just because I haven't looked at it very much. With more experience, I'm sure there'll be routes that are useless. That is, no one in there who has any experience with the game would ever choose those particular techs, and then it'll become much more linear and boring. But right now, it's been a lot of fun to poke around with, so I'm pleased with the tech web at present. I can't say if it's an improvement.
Another siege room has appeared.
Just
these other guys are dealing with siege rooms. We're dealing with a bulk of aliens, and we've been fighting them a lot, so I'm surprised they haven't gotten more aggressive and sent a siege worm in. I'm glad they haven't. I'm not entirely sure what sort of how your interactions with the aliens affect what they end up doing. Let's grab a trade convoy, and then we'll soon have enough energy to buy out another colonist. And this soldier can go and sneak by, although he will be surrounded by units, but hopefully... Alright, we'll take the insta-heal here and deal damage there. I don't want the colonist to be destroyed. Let's build out a road. Are the hotkeys still the same? Yes, road. Oh, and this worker is now fully healed. He can get back on that miasma, do his business, get that titanium hooked up. And we can settle this city. Not on the crash satellite. We'll send an explorer over to that. And I guess we have a resync.
Okay, I'm gonna resync. Are you guys gonna resync?
Yeah, resync here too. And Twitch or OBS is warning me that we've got a high CPU usage alert. I guess briefly, as Civ resynced, it chewed up a lot of CPU. But we're good.
Not even sure if it's a resync. I just have a black screen now. All right, only... I'm gonna consider this a crash, and I'll get a reload up.
Sure. We do have 1.9% dropped frames, but I assume it hasn't affected stream quality too much. Alright, so if Filthy is reloading, can we? We can't escape. Alright, so let's flip over to the standby screen and restart Civ.
Reloads up.
By the way, those of you who commented on my last request for input on the various Civ or channel logos that I've been putting together, what do you think of the latest iteration? I like it. Fruitstrike did comment that the spaceship does look a little phallic. I don't think it does, and that's only because I first modeled the spaceship off of the Civ-4 Science Victory spaceship, and that ship looked phallic when I drew the silhouette. But the Civ-5 Science Victory ship, Alpha Centauri ship, looks like a ship to me. In fact, it looks just like, or very similar to the NASA concept rocket that I am using for the back image splash. Anyways, looks like we are ready to go here. That's interesting. We get the high CPU usage warning every time they're or at the intro screen. And I think the last time we had the weird reverb was whenever we hit high CPU usage and the program never recovered. So, if someone in chat could warn me if something has happened to my voice, I'd appreciate that. Otherwise, we are loading up and it is taking a long time. Alright, so we're back in. We are connected to everyone. All's well. And it's the next turn. We can get our soldier into position here. I think that should be safe. Yeah, there's another manticore. We'll want to keep on pushing with these rovers then, because I do not want to risk losing that colonist. But we can't get in much further. There is a zone of control issues. Alright, if we attack here, we'll take 16 damage, another 10 from the miasma. We should be able to attack or take attacks from the wolf beetle, in which case, no, we can't curve around. Alright, we'll just keep on attacking here. Robot man again, but it cleared up. Okay, so we don't have any weird echo, I'm assuming. We're good to go. And construct that mine. Great. Alright, this guy should probably take some time for his health. And we'll head over here to finish that route. Alright, so we've made this lower area safe and free from aliens so far. So we can get these extremely necessary trade routes going. And back over in the city, we've got another trade convoy up. And next turn we can settle this guy. And we can also pump out some sea-based... Oh geez, did we lose anyone? No, we didn't. The aliens just suicided themselves against us. And back here, is it time for a colonist? I do believe it is. What's our trade route number looking like? We have space for many more. Alright, we'll do another trade convoy. Choose production here. Let's go for that. Got the old Earth relic. We got... Well, we need the trade depot, but I might rush by that instead. Let's go... Four turns on the trade depot, fine. We won't rush by that, but... Deals damage here. Veterancy gained. I think it's less urgent now. We'll go drop an outpost. This worker has finished his road. Probably wants to hide somewhere. Pull back here to put up a farm. And these guys, I don't want to use all of their veterancy on instant heals, so we'll take seasoned and hide in the city. And these guys will just pull back to here. And you'll fortify on that hill. Alright, missile rover is getting into position. As should have a range attack of 2, so we'll set up for range attack there. Trade route internal. And worker will heal. Veterancy gained here. Probably need an instant heal. Did we take an instant heal? I thought we clicked on that. Veterancy. We grab the attack bonus. Alright, so that mine's done. Now we've got 6 production off of those yields. Awesome. Let's get a paddock going. And the combat rover will want to fortify until healed. This city is growing into a whole bunch of aliens around that do need to be cleared out, but our army can take some time to heal. Do we need another trade convoy? Well, let's make sure the trade convoys that we just got out can actually go places. Well, we don't want to send him over this way because of all the aliens, so back to the fort. Trade convoy finishing in one turn. Excellent. We got the huge production boost off of that last trade convoy, and so it's the trade depot that's finishing a lot sooner. This worker can get over here and start on a farm. So no code, Sino code. I call this competitive multiplayer to distinguish it from multiplayer that other people seem to play, where they play with AI or play cooperatively with their friends. Alright, so we can't establish a trade route. We can change the origin city once 19 gets its trade depot going. And this combat rover will need to heal up inside the city. And we could attack Shackleton, and we will. Alright, choosing production here. Alien Preserve, we finally picked up that tech. We're working on robotics. And let's grab the... Well, we are unhealthy, the Pharma Lab. Do we have the Pharma Lab in the capital? We need to activate these again. We don't, and I would like to get the bonuses from the Rome-like unique ability in the Industry Virtue Tree. So instead, we'll just go and work on the Recycler for now, which we do have in the capital. Don't we? Yes, we have the Recycler. And sure, we could build out an alien preserve, although science is probably going to be better for us here. Yeah, I want to get that science up. And sure, let's grab a Recycler. And we'll reassign those trade units as needed. Alright, we will need a melee unit. And send him over to 19. This guy as well. Alright, that looks fine. The aliens are not attacking the outpost, which is good. We do have a soldier in there healing up, so we do have better defense values than we might otherwise. But we are completely surrounded by aliens here, so that could be trouble. Yes, we should go and build ourselves the spy network, which might be better than this network. Although the network here would get us science sooner, those spies probably amount to, I don't know, between 2 and 10 science per turn. But the science stealing mission, we probably won't be able to get a lot online right away. At least based on what we've seen when playing against the AI. Now, our opponents here might be living their lives a little more unhealthily, which means we'll probably have more intrigue, which means we could get the science stealing going right away. Ah, Kalishkova says that he or she, I don't know what to make of that name. My apologies there again. Not that it matters what your gender is, at least to me. All my stream viewers are equal. But anyways, compliments me on the quality of my play compared to other multiplayer streamers who did not play single player first. So I hope that's true and that all of you guys are enjoying the stream. Alright, trade convoy. What do we want here? We could grow this out, but we really need to get rid of those aliens. And I actually want sea-based convoys here. So, we need a colonist. A colonist is going to cost us 270, 470. So we're going to have to hard build that. That means the capital will go spy agency. Kiyun will add to queue, recycler into colonist, that's going to be 6 turns, that'll be fine, we'll settle him over here, and then we'll push our army northwards, but we do need to send over someone to pick up Shackleton. We could rush by an explorer out of 19. Explorer, we need space there, or just send this rover down, fine. Alright, so at the moment we have too many trade depots, or trade vessels, trade land, trade people. And so that's something that we'll correct in future playthroughs, getting a good sense of exactly how many we need and when. But at the moment these guys are just going to have to sit there and do nothing. Yes, silly pseudonym, that's right. Everyone gets equally special treatment. Ah, but with this worker, what do I want to do? Let's just, since we've got so many workers, we'll have him fortify until healed. And we'll take this down. The combat rover, well, we'll get some experience on him even if we can't kill him. And we do, over here, choose production. Some basics might be nice. Since we are unhealthy, let's grab the Seto Nursery, and I really want an explorer to pick this stuff up. Purchase explorer, only 140. The explorer will go grab that derelict settlement and then this crashed satellite. And our soldier now is fully healed. I don't think, well, alright, let's attack the Manticore. He has almost no combat strength, it's all range strength that makes him scary. And does that mean we are safe to trade now? No, no it is not, and in fact, we'd go around the long way because of all this miasma blocking the trade route, which makes it very unsafe. All right, this guy will want to pull back somewhere safer to heal. Oh, that's also Miasma. All right, this is Miasma free, fortify. We almost lost the unit to carelessness there. And we will one day, so prepare yourself mentally if you find that kind of mistake painful. All right, do I want a farm or a generator? Let's diversify. We've built mostly farms recently. Toss up a generator. Yes, it is really funny how we discovered the derelict settlement, even though we were the... Well, it's true, we discovered it after creating it by, launching our missiles and coming in with our combat rover. As it is, we'll move these guys around this way. I don't think there are any aliens to the south, and I hope that no new aliens spawn.
Aliens mad at me.
How'd you do it?
I took their nest. They're all orange.
Oh, wow.
Alright, let's kill this Manticore, although it would leave us standing in Miasma. We'll attack here. Trade vessels, I'm very sorry about all of this. And I kind of wish you were trade vessels, actually. Robotics in 7, so we'll get the auto plants going. I don't know if I want to delete those guys then, and plus we're about to settle some more, so that'll all be fine. Alright, let's get these units in here, dealing our damage. So am I going to plant right there? I think I'm going to plant either there or down here. Planting further south does get me the silica and the petroleum, and that way it'll leave the explorer with time to harvest whatever salvage you can get from that derelict settlement. So yeah, we're going to settle down here. And that does mean, I think the explorer will be enough to keep an eye on this area, make sure it's safe for a colonist to wander in on his own. And we lost our soldier. That's too bad. Veterancy gained here, though. We'll grab the attack bonus. Kill one of these Manticores. Decisive victory. We have to stand on Miasma in either case. So many aliens need killing. Alright, so he's now healed. This guy. Let's pull over here. Missile rovers will get into position. The explorer will double check that we don't need to bring more units around to protect the settler. And these combat rovers want to heal up or get right into the action. Decisive victory, major victory. Well, fine. We'll stand here and heal. Yeah. You guys are right, I will want sea-based resources, so let's just leave these guys. But I don't want to delete these, they'll still be useful for these cities that can't make trade vessels once they have their auto plants up. So we'll leave those guys there for now, and I don't have time to build out trade vessels either. Well, I kind of do, but trade vessel, 2 turns. How long is it going to take the settler to get over there? Alright, we'll go and build out a lab. We do get the 25% production boost there, which is awesome. And a quest decision, energy from thorium or production. Let's go with the 2 energy. I'd rather 2 energy than 1 production. We can split that over. Trade convoy. Alright, a unit needs orders. This guy is taking damage from standing on that, but he's going to move south to start preparing the groundwork for our next colony, which is going to be right here. We won't be able to improve the float stone, but we could at least get a road going. Say, mountain will be in the way there. So probably 1, 2, 3, 4 over this way. Well, that is a bit of a waste. Fine, let's just go put a farm or generator on this miasma. This guy is low on farms, so construct a farm there. And we'll set up and bombard. Combat rover time. Boom. Minor victory. This guy is actually pretty close to dying. We should hide him somewhere. Maybe back here. But we'll replace him with this combat rover. Standing in miasma, at least he'll back up his other combat rover friend. And these embarrassing trade convoys are just sitting there. We don't have enough to rush by a colonist. Okay, choosing production. 19. Could pump out a trade vessel. Gangzorig should become a full city. Well, it has two more tiles that it needs to expand to, and that'll take at least 4 turns. We could pop out a quick gunboat, do some exploring there. Or we could grab some of these basics. Did we finish the network? Yes, we did. So more science with the network. Pharma lab to commerce of that. Do we have the thorium reactor in our capital already? Yes, we do. All right, so we get the production bonus there. We'll work on the thorium reactor. I think our current military will be enough to deal with these bugs, but we really do need to make sure we don't lose any units, especially by accidentally parking them on miasma. Range of 2 only, so this guy's gonna have to move up, and unfortunately I think he does need line of sight. We can't hide. We'll only take 14 damage killing that wolf beetle, so this guy shouldn't be able to kill us, although, yeah, we'll be fine. And we've just met Cleftor's explorer. All of his explorers weren't killed by Baba Yetu, that troublemaking fiend. Alright, leave that there. Combat rover wants to heal. And this guy will work on a plantation. Great. Alright, choosing production. Our colonist finishes next turn. We'll probably want another colonist. Let's grab a quick alien preserve. Oh no, we want the spy agency. Alright, all of those who are clamoring for a spy agency, work has finally begun. And that long-awaited settler. We wanted to settle the spot pretty much from the beginning of the game. We'll send him down now that the old settlement here has been eliminated. Now, do I want to go for another colonist here, or do we have time to pick something else up? Laboratory is only going to take 2 turns, but that's probably because of some overflow from the colonist. Do I have a spot picked out? I do want to send something up here, but I won't have cleared all of that out within 5 turns. So, we can take some time to go and push out a laboratory. And this missile rover does have a target. Let's see if this forest blocks line of sight. It does. That's a little unfortunate, I suppose. We could major victory there, but then we'd die next turn, so let's hide inside the outpost, fortify, heal, trade convoy, pass turn, sleep, Get ready to hook up that Reslin. We'll buy the tile if it's not hooked up next turn. And yeah, we'll get the missile rover into position. Combat rover, get into the city to heal faster. And the explorer's done there. We'll get back here, grab a new expedition module, and then pick up this crashed satellite. Colonist wants to head over here or here. Either is fine. This spot lets me pick up the petroleum, and so I'd rather that. And the music is quite nice. How are the music volumes doing? Uncanny Luck wants me to spy on Filthy's capital and coup his city. I can only imagine how entertaining his reaction would be. It's only possible to do the coups if Filthy is extremely unhappy. I don't know how he plays or how experienced he is with respect to the health system, so I guess it is possible we'd be able to pull off a coup. That would be pretty hilarious. Ooh, and what's going on here? We've got a crashed satellite. Someone just deorbited something. Crashed satellites everywhere. Or maybe some of those were errant artifacts. No, we definitely have a crashed satellite there. There could be one right over here too. And the music is... I am really liking this music. Let me know how the volume sounds on your end. Alright, set up and bombard. And how is the rover in this city doing? He surely didn't get killed.
I'm gonna need that crash satellite, I'm afraid.
It's for my quest.
Is it really?
Listen yeah. to them fight.
Alright, I'll make
it. So if you want the petroleum, we're gonna head down south to here.
Because
and you guys can't hear the music at all. Options, audio options, let's push the music up to 50%. And return to game. Alright, so let me know how that works out for music. Also let me know how the chatter from the guys on TeamSpeak is filtering in, if that needs to be raised or lowered. Alright, trade convoys, yes, yes, there's nothing for you to do. Well, has anything changed? Establish a trade route all the way around here, yeah, that's not going to be safe for us. So yes, please keep sleeping. Once this guy gets up and running, we can send some of the trade routes to this outpost. But I will want a mix of naval routes going here as well. Alright, so we haven't expanded to the Reslin. We are going to expand there naturally in some number of turns, but we'll just spend the 30 energy to buy that out and start work on that paddock right away. Extra science and extra culture. Definitely nice, and we're going to hit robotics
I
next turn.
Remember this. So.
Okay.
Kalashkova wants to see some weather satellite action. I'm assuming that boosts our food yields. But what I want is the Planet Carver. That thing looked pretty awesome, and if you can get it out early, I think it'd be super powerful. We used it really late in our DD Apollo playthrough, so it was just a nice artillery unit, but if we use that early, I think we need 4 petroleum and 1 titanium, or maybe it's reversed. So we definitely want to glob up as much petroleum as we can find. The city spot down here would be terrible, though. Wait there, you can get into position, nothing dangerous. Trade convoy, explorer, module recharged, let's get over here. And how's that armor doing? It is at 44 hit points, you can stay home for now. Maybe the Manticore will attack that explorer. And choosing production, is it time for an auto plant? No, I'd rather get the production boost. Although, that's kind of silly given all the benefits we get from the auto plant. Fine, let's get the alien preserve and we'll pull the auto plant up. first here. Although we don't have the alien preserved here either. Maybe I'm being a little too silly trying to make sure we get the 25 production boost by having the building first in our capital. So let's change that. Add to queue. I definitely want the auto plant. Although the thorium reactor. All right. Cancel. Up. Cancel. And then into auto plant. And then perhaps we'll get some of the production boost because I'm going to work on the auto plant after the spy agency finishes. All right. So do I want to get more yield from internal trade routes? Yes, most definitely. And an auto plant or a network. Let's go for the network here. Although more units, since we do have more guys to be hitting. What do I want next? We're gonna need more affinity points, but we're just fighting the aliens, so I don't think we'll need ecology for the ultrasonic fence. We do have some geothermal though, so let's head over to that. Although I think with the turn rolling over, we weren't able to select anything. So maybe the science there went to waste. That would be too bad. Geothermal well. We do have geothermal, right? I thought I saw some that ion. It's just the one geothermal there. And we can start improving the pyraxite. So where are all my workers? Forget these farms. Farms are boring. But all of the pyraxite is... Well, that pyraxite's not on miasma. Alright, workers. Get your priorities straight, please. Boost that. Settle this. Right here. And our units need orders. Missile rover. Bombard. Combat rover. Kill him. And finally, we have a safe place to send this route. More or less safe. I'm not entirely sure. There could be some guys hiding down here, but it's much safer than to the north. And Phyraxite is pure science. Where is my Phyraxite science boosting building? That's what I want to get. There is a building that I came across, and I researched in our deity game, but was really disappointed that I couldn't build it because it required Phyraxite, and I think it was a different affinity tree to follow. But that's not a problem for us this game. Now, should we just kill this guy? I think we should. I don't want him to steal this crashed satellite that I have down here. We will need to send an explorer down there eventually. And yes, we could trade here, but that's not going to be safe, so that's going to have to sleep for a little while longer.